Hey, is Utah ready to take on the challenge of starting high school later in the day?
Interesting question here. Parents in Park City petitioned for this change earlier this spring. So, Deanie, weigh the benefits versus realities of high school life. Deanie, what'd you find out?
Well, if you just look at what's best for kids, the evidence is overwhelming. Starting school later helps teenagers. But as all parents know, the crush of after-school activities can really make this a tough call.
Morning comes early for high schoolers like Efren Valeriano, who start AP Physics lab by 6:30.
I have a hard time, just kind of comprehending what's happening.
Tonight, you actually have a three-part assignment.
I'm just tired. I usually fall asleep in class, just pass out on the desk.
I'm not talking to anybody besides maybe my guy sitting next to me.
They're not talking and they're not complaining. They all chose to be here.
So you can't take AP Physics B without taking the lab class.
I couldn't really take the lab class after school because, again, everyone's in after school sports.
There are a lot of motivated kids that come in early, a lot of sleepy kids that come in.
Now, in fairness, there are kids who will just simply not sign up for my physics class because they say, I can't get myself out of bed at that time of the day.
I just saw my daughter getting sleep deprived as the week wore on and then trying to catch up on the weekend.
A group of Park City parents petitioned to start high school later at 8:30.
And I hadn't realized how overwhelming the body of research was until then.
The American Academy of Pediatrics earlier this year reported lack of sleep not only hurts academic performance, it's tied to all kinds of things. Poor health, depression, anxiety, faulty judgment, even car crashes.
I think every school district really should look at it very seriously.
We did look at this last year.
As Superintendent Ember Conley agrees, the research is undeniable, but so are the costs.
A major driver of any school district is transportation.
They'd need more buses with more schools now starting at the same time, $600,000 worth. Hiring more drivers and yearly upkeep, another $250,000. Those are just part of the costs.
The after-school activities, kids who have to work after school, and how do you minimize that impact if they have to stay in school for an extra hour?
Teenagers, even tired ones, say those are the real roadblocks.
I understand that they don't want to conflict with after-school sports. It's just hard getting to sleep early. It's either one or the other.
A study from the University of Minnesota this year looked at schools near Minneapolis, Boulder, Colorado, and Jackson Hole, Wyoming that started later. Researchers found grades and test scores increased at statistically significant levels. Car crashes in Wyoming dropped 70%.
We know that lack of sleep affects the brain's ability to focus, pay attention, to handle complex problems.
Perhaps the best case for later start times.
Good morning, it's 8 o'clock.
Is already attending Park City High.
I just got up. I'm definitely a lot happier than I am at 6 a.m.
Rachel Frayne has parent release for first period and arrives at school at 9 o'clock.
My parents were okay with that.
As long as she meets graduation requirements, the school allows parent release.
If I can, write essays, do whatever I need to do at 9 in the morning because I've had that extra 2 hours of sleep that my other friends haven't.
She's a Sterling Scholar and will attend University of Southern California next fall on a presidential scholarship. So, obviously, her competitiveness wasn't compromised by extra sleep.
It raises a debate, certainly. Park City School District is moving forward with plans, at least to look at finances and public input. But the superintendent told me it's doable. If they do move this direction, the aim would be to start in the fall of 2016.
Fascinating. I got my extra.